So, fun thing, I actually recorded at least 6 minutes of this before Audacity fucking crashed. So, I get to re-record all of this. It's a long ass script, and I have to re-record it. So cool. Anyway, hey guys, Dan here again with another voiceover video. Yay! Because you all love these, they get tons of views. Anyway, today I wanted to talk about a topic that I've recently gotten weirdly passionate about, but have been kind of flip-floppy on in the past. It's a really divisive subject, so I expect. God, I cannot fucking talk. So I expect a lot of people to disagree with me on it, but that's okay. I get it. So, let's talk about closed species. What are they, and why are they so goddamn popular? For those of you who don't want to look it up, a closed species is basically an original species someone creates and then allows people to create their own members of said species with permission. Permission can come in the form of money payment, vouchers, gifts, raffles, and other events. Basically, closed species are species that you are not free to make your own of without explicit permission from the creator. There's also open species, which are original species that are free for anyone to make, and semi-closed species, which are open species that have some restrictions on them, so they're basically a mix between open and closed species. But today I want to focus on the closed species specifically. First, I'll go over why I think people tend to hate closed species, at least from what I've heard and seen online, because holy shit, I cannot have a conversation about closed species without someone immediately being like, this is stupid. You know, like, any fucking ways. Like I mentioned before, you aren't allowed to make your own character of a closed species without permission of some kind. And I guess people don't really like that. Like, if you make your own without having like a make your own voucher or having like a slot or whatever, then it won't be considered official, and you'll probably be put on a blacklist for the species, and you won't be able to like interact with it. So I've seen people argue that you can't own a broad concept like a species, which is true, and that making them close to the public is dumb because of that. Another reason people tend to hate closed species is the price. I've seen closed species adoptables go for literally hundreds of dollars. I'm sure by now most of you have heard of the famous 20K Grimm 2. That's a more extreme case, but a lot of people. I always fucking do that. I did that last time I recorded. A lot of adopts still do regularly go for more than 200 at the very least. One more reason I see people throwing around is creativity or lack thereof. A lot of closed species tend to be a mix of animals or a mix of animals and objects, such as water dogs, sushi dogs, cine dogs, fox fans. You get the idea. No shade to any of these. It's just, you know, just examples. People say that these aren't very original or creative, and that they shouldn't be charging hundreds for a dog with a banana on its ass. Another thing that I've seen people complain about is how if you make a character with a similar trait to a popular closed species, like a curly tail or glass horns, or, you know, just something simple like that, even not on purpose, it's very common to get attacked and harassed for it, which is obviously uncool. The last thing I'll mention is a personal gripe that I share with a lot of people, which is how toxic the communities around the closed species can get. They tend to use their species as a status symbol and something to brag about and hang over the heads of those less fortunate than them. They're just really clicky, if that makes sense. All of these opinions are valid reasons to dislike closed species, honestly. Like, making a species that's just an animal with a fruit attached to it and then charging a lot of money for the right to make your own sounds super ridiculous. I honestly agree with a lot of these people. Sometimes closed species can be, to put it bluntly, dumb, and I understand that. However, I also have some opinions that I could argue against a lot of the gripes people have with closed species. That's basically what this video is going to be about, so straddle in. That is not the right term. Anyway, I'll preface this by saying that in the past, I've gone on record to say that I myself dislike closed species and thought they were stupid like a lot of people do. However, after some thought, I've kind of come around on them, and I'm actually in the process of developing one myself, but I won't get into that. I'm just throwing it out there, I have made open species too, so I'm not just like jumping on the train, you know? So, to address the first point, it's true that you can't claim ownership over a broad concept or idea like a species. Copyright does not work like that. Like people have said, no one can stop anybody from taking aspects of a design or species they like and using them for their own characters and designs. And honestly, it's silly to try and enforce that, especially with something like a closed species on DeviantArt that isn't legally protected by trademark. Except for that one species I can never remember. I think it's sushi dogs. Anyway, I honestly don't see this as the big issue here. In my opinion, it's not a matter of whether or not people can make similar or inspired creations, but rather a matter of people having the right to have their own damn idea and take credit for it like they should be able to. Listen, think of it this way. If you make an OC that's completely original, like the species is a completely original creature for your own usage. You'd feel weird if someone made one of the same creature for their own without asking you first, right? Like, you'd at least want to be credited as the original creator of that creature, surely. You'd probably feel even worse if that person tried to sell off more characters using that creature design without your permission. This is how I see closed species working. Someone creates a species, and it's theirs. They should be able to do whatever they want with their own creation, including sell permission to make another member of said species. Or not. If they want to keep it completely closed so only they can use it, that's their choice and it should be respected. That's what it is for me, a matter of respect. If someone creates a species and you look at it and decide, I'm gonna copy this because I can, then you're just being an asshole at that point. Like, it's literally like copying someone's OC just because you can. Like, of course you can. Anyone could just draw what they want to draw, I guess. But the question isn't whether or not you can, but rather whether or not you should. It's a matter of respecting someone's right to have their own ideas and be recognized for that. That's the biggest thing for me. I don't think people register that stealing a closed species just because they don't want to pay for it is still stealing someone's creation. Since when did we just decide that theft was okay, anyway? Like, people get upset when they find people using the same damn pose or palette as them, so why is species theft suddenly a fine thing to do too? That's just my onion, though. So, the second thing I'd like to address is the price. Here we fucking go. At first glance, someone charging $200 for a colorful dog with wings seems a little silly, I know. But I guess I want to bring up the fact that a lot of these adopts that sell for high prices are auctions, meaning people bid to make the price go up that high voluntarily. I know some are flat sales, but I can justify these as well. The designers, I'm pretty sure, didn't start selling their adopts for such high prices, at least not at first. What happened was the demand for their designs grew over time, like their popularity grew, and that made it more reasonable for them to charge more for them. It's basically supply and demand. Closed species have an exclusivity and rarity to them that creates a high demand for them, and that drives up the prices up. Drives up the prices up. Thank you, Dan. As for MYOs, which stands for make your owns, I'll just say make your owns from now on because MYO does not roll off the tongue, thanks Stan. I've seen them go pretty high as well. Like, I remember back when I was into water dogs, I paid fucking $90 for two slots to make my own water dog. Like, a common water dog that wasn't really exciting, you know? Like, it was just a basic, you know. I think this follows the same logic. Make your own slots are rare, so that means there's a high demand for them, and that means the creators can jack up the prices for them if they want to. Having said all this, cash payment isn't the only way to get your hands on a closed species, contrary to popular belief, I think. While these events don't happen often and are more of a game of chance than a for sure way to obtain a species, it's still a viable and free way of getting one. Usually, closed species have events such as raffles or giveaways that let you have the chance to earn a make your own slot or a pre-made design for free. On top of that, some species groups also have their own currency, which can also be used for vouchers and such. If you're lucky and have connections, gifts are another way, free way, of receiving a species. People generally get upset that they can't afford a closed species, and that's why they dislike them. But I'm going to point something out to you that you really need to understand. Closed species, much like art in general, are a luxury. Like, they're not essential items you need to own. They're like toys, or gaming consoles, or expensive clothes. You're not entitled to owning one of these just because you're not in, well, just as you're not entitled to getting a drawing for free. Like, that pisses me off so fucking much. When the people are like, oh, I love your art. Can you draw this for free? Like, no. No, I can't. People also use closed species as a means of income, just like they would commissions or regular adoptables. As an artist who makes a living off of these things as well, like I literally do commissions for a living full time, I think a lot of people underestimate how important and vital these things are for us, and I feel like people should cut closed species owners some slack for their pricing with this in mind. Now, about the creative aspect. This is one thing I'm kind of on both sides of. I can see why people dislike a lot of species, specifically the ones that are just animals with inorganic parts. Again, no shade, but, like, I get it. Slapping a horn onto a cat and calling it a species isn't that original or exciting. I can definitely see why people get upset when these types of species become popular and are high-priced. However, not all closed species are like this. In fact, there's a ton of cool and original closed species out there with interesting lore, unique worlds, and cool design traits. You can easily clock a character as one of these species if they're designed well enough. Just to go on a little tangent here, in regards to species traits, in my honest opinion, if your species is so widely varied with possible traits to the point of where people can basically make a regular-ass dog and slap the species name onto it, I don't think it's a good species. I'll admit it, I'm talking about a specific species right now. One that starts with a C. I'm not gonna name drop, but draw your own conclusions. Again, no shade, I love them. I do. I love closed species, and that one in particular, for sure. But, God, like, the other day I literally saw a fucking... It was a dog. It was a dog. And it was called one of the species. The species looks nothing like that! Any fucking ways. I think a good species needs some limitations, so that it doesn't end up losing its recognizability, if that makes sense. I think this would solve a lot of the problems people have where they accidentally make a design that looks similar to a closed species, or at least help with the matter, you know? In any case, harassment over some fucking lines is really stupid no matter how you slice it. Do not take that out of context. I swear to God, if you guys use that line that I just said to justify drawing nasty shit, I'm going to, like, come into your house and beat you with a bat. I swear to God. Anyway, to use that as a segue into my last point, I'm going to address my own gripe, which is the toxic communities around closed species. This is honestly still a valid reason to dislike them, but I'm gonna play devil's advocate here and say that as far as I know, most species owners don't condone harassment over similar designs or ripoffs or whatever. When you have such a large community around something, it's really hard and pretty much impossible to control everyone's actions. Honestly, fandoms is the same, and there's always going to be toxic parts of every fandom, so my advice is to find some people you vibe with and create your own little bubble in the fandom of your choice. You don't have to engage with the negative parts if you don't want to. Make your own community within the community that makes you feel comfortable and allows you to enjoy the fandom like you should. Now, as for the other part of my gripe, the clicks and shit, I still do have a problem with those. I hate how people use their ownership as a way to seem superior to those who can't afford a species character of their own. It's really mean and unnecessarily snooty. Like, you literally paid $70 for a dog with a strawberry ass. Congrats. You ain't as special as you think you are, King. Anyway, closing thoughts, I guess. Oh my God, this video is almost 15 minutes long. Here I go again. Classic Dan. Anyway, closed species are hated for a lot of reasons, but I think people don't put enough effort into understanding them from a creator's point of view. There are a lot of issues with the community, yeah, but that's not really the species owner's fault. Well, usually, that's just a thing that happens when a lot of people come together around an interest. Honestly, I think closed species are fine, and if you don't like them, then just don't engage with them. Literally do something else. It's an open species, like, or make an open species if you're so upset. Like, make an OC that's inspired by the species if you want, just don't straight up steal the designs, because again, that's going into dickhead territory. The whole closed species revolution or whatever the fuck, where people make off-brand species to sell for dirt cheap or free, is just really stupid to me, and honestly pretty petty and disrespectful from an artist's perspective. You really out here letting closed species live in your head rent-free? Like, put your energy into more productive things and stop being so angry at something so harmless. Anyway, this is all my onion, opinion, whatever. Feel free to disagree if you wanna, I don't really care. I've said my piece and I don't really wanna debate anymore. Anyway, have a good one, follow me on Twitter or something, bye.